some of the keys tonight is just mainly handling the five out. So we're just going over our guys, you know, 71st like to pass and cut through down the middle of the lane, and we're just showing guys where they need to be, whether we in a zone, a man, any type of defense that we're running. It's something we do every game. We get a few keys from either last year's film, and we watch and go over it as coaches and sit down and discuss the game plan and what we need to do. Tonight is just, you know, basically putting guys in place and stopping the five out.
Yeah. Look, the real is back, the veil is back. Flow bananas hit, peel the spec. And what you'll find is your highness could paint a picture that's vivid enough to cure blindness. Carolina's finest, you knew that already.
Last week we lost two close games. We could be 5-1. Tonight we're going in 0-0, but we're playing, you know, one of the better teams in the conference. I believe it was conference champs last year. Conference tournament champions, so it's a good start. 0-0, everybody's 0-0.
Yeah.
We get this win tonight, you know, that's a big time win for us. You know, regardless of what we've done in the last few weeks, what the overall record shows.
And that's the danger, know me better than I know myself. I rip a page out my notebook in anger and let these thoughts linger, singing. Don't give them too much you. Don't let them take control. One thing you do, don't let them take your soul.
Tuesday night, the Jack Britt Buccaneers were on the road against the 71st Falcons. For both teams, this was the conference opener, and the win would be a great confidence builder moving forward. Starting right off, 71st applied full court pressure that caused Jack Britt to turn over the ball repeatedly, putting 71st in transition to convert easy layups. For the first couple of possessions, Jack Britt struggled to find any rhythm in the half court. On defense, Britt was also a step behind to rebounds and loose balls. 71st seemed to be two steps faster on both ends. Trey Hills knocked down 2 3-pointers and made strong drives to the cup to keep Britt striking range. By the end of the first quarter, 71st lead 25-12. Second quarter, Britt was able to limit turnovers and end defensive possessions with box out and rebounds, and closed on the first lead. 71st was able to get to the basket at will with dribble drives and convert layups, which allowed them to keep a steady 7-point lead at the half. At the start of the second half, again, Jack Britt continued to struggle with turnovers and closing possessions with box out. 71st did a good job with sticking to their game plan, applying pressure on the very limited ball handlers of Britt. This would be the downside of Britt throughout the whole second half. 71st cruised the easy victory with the final score 72-56. 71st improved to 1-0, while Britt will play its next game, searching for its first conference win.